or sponsors.
Would you like answers to life's questions? Then join me, Sarah Spiritual, every Wednesday evening from 5 to 8 p.m. for Spiritually Speaking with Sarah right here on 95.3 The Talk, WNN 1470 AM. See you there.
Talk 1470 is WWNN Pompano Beach and 95.3 FM W237BD Boca Raton, the Health and Wealth Radio Network.
Want to lower your rate and payments, get rid of mortgage insurance, or get cash out? Find out about your best refinance options by tuning into the Get Mortgage Fit radio show with Alex Michaels and Carrie Kasem, Monday mornings from 10 to 11, where you'll learn everything you need to know about mortgage loans, today's rates, FHA, VA, and more. Call the Get Mortgage Fit show Monday mornings from 10 to 11 on WNN at 800-827-RATE, 800-827-RATE, or visit them online at newamericanfunding.com, NMLS 6606.
Peter Herrick was a 34-year-old carpenter when he joined the Navy Reserve. Peter's wife, Diana.
They were deployed to build schools and bases and to assist the Marines.
When the mortar round hit, I was completely knocked out. I didn't wake up until 6 days later.
Paralyzed veteran, senior National Service officer, Raymond Bruce.
I saw Pete when he was at his worst. He didn't know if he was going to live to be able to see his daughter graduate from high school.
Raymond knew that I needed help figuring out where do we go from here.
We not only represent the veteran, but we represent the whole family.
11 months we stayed in the hospital down in Tampa.
We advocate, we educate, and we process claims through the VA, and we follow that claim from the beginning to the end.
Without Paralyzed Veterans of America, I really honestly believe I'd still be in the hospital.
You can help our paralyzed veterans. To learn more, visit pva.org. A public service of Paralyzed Veterans of America.
After the phone interview, I assumed the apartment was mine. But when I got to the place and the manager saw me, he told me it was no longer available.
My husband and I wanted to see all the neighborhoods with great schools. But our real estate agent only showed us the communities where she thought we would be more comfortable.
I was so excited to move into my new place, but now that I'm here, I found out that the landlord is charging me higher rent than my neighbors. Now that doesn't make me feel very welcome.
These individuals may have experienced housing discrimination. The Fair Housing Act prohibits discrimination because of race, color, national origin, religion, sex, disability, and familial status. If you've experienced discrimination, call 1-800-669-9777. Or visit www.hud.gov/fairhousing. Live free from housing discrimination.
Are you thinking about getting your GED diploma? Well, here at the GED Pep Talk Center, we've got a number of pep talks that can motivate you.
Sometimes things don't always turn out the way you want them to.
You know that feeling? People look at you and don't believe in you.
You want some gentle encouragement. Then you're on your way to your GED diploma and a better life.
But I know you're probably just a little bit nervous.
You can find it in yourself to take that first step.
You can improve your future.
You can do this. I know you can.
You need to start pushing yourself.
Now get your game face on and take the first step towards a better life. Hurry up. Don't make me repeat myself.
Whatever level of motivation you need to get your GED diploma, we've got a pep talk that's right for you. Call 1-877-38-YOUR-GED or visit yourged.org for your pep talk and find free GED classes in your area. GED is a registered trademark of the American Council on Education, brought to you by Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
What you want to know. What you need to know. Talk 1470 WNN.
The opinions expressed in the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of the station, its staff, management, or sponsors. Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert co-hosts and guests, will tell you where to go. To play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube. And tonight, like we typically do, we're going to talk a bunch of golf and we will talk some travel. And got some deals for you a little bit later on in the show, of course. Going to send you pretty far away and maybe not so far away as well, but always at the right price. Also, in just a few moments, we will be talking to a gentleman representing a company that manufactures a product which is, in the past, would have been very unlikely for me to use because it happens to be a product called InPut, and it is a putting training aid. And any of you who know me know that I, in the past, had been untrainable, both by my lack of wanting to practice as well as my problem that I faced with the yips, which kind of made almost everything else worthless as far as training on putting. But now that I've gotten rid of my yips, I do need some help and for the rest of my putting game. And this product, InPut, is a pretty cool device to help you with your alignment and your stroke. So a little bit later, we'll be talking to a fellow by the name of Jason Kleindienst, and he's the VP of Operations for InPut. And I'm looking forward to that because anything that I can learn about helping my putting is welcome. And, of course, hopefully we can help you all, too. As always, in the beginning of the show, we talk a little more golf and then we talk a little more travel later on in the show. And I typically do not talk too much about what's going on the tour. As you know, while we are live on Friday nights at 7 o'clock on WNN 1470 and 95.3, we also rerun the show 6 p.m. on our sister station WSBR 740 a.m., 96.9 FM and 103.9 FM. So, I don't like for the news to be too old, and when you talk about the news, obviously it can get old. But there are a couple of things I wanted to touch on from the tour last week as well as this week and as well as next week. So if you don't mind, please bear with me, and I apologize for anybody who's going to get news that's not current, but it's my show, so bear with me. Anyway, last week, I was watching on TV quite a bit of the Pebble Beach Pro-Am. Hopefully some of you were doing the same. And every year, I don't know how it happens, but it seems that the scenery at Pebble Beach just gets better and better. It was just absolutely breathtaking. I truly enjoyed just watching it. The other thing about the event that I found interesting, don't ask me why, but the actual pro-am part, the pro part went to Ted Potter Jr., who I think his biggest paycheck as a golf pro was $33,000 prior to this. So that was a big story. But for me, on the celebrity side, the winner was Larry Fitzgerald from the Arizona Cardinals, and I just wanted to, I mean, I may have said this before, but I want to say it again. Several years ago, my daughter interned at the Phoenix Children's Hospital, and Larry Fitzgerald would frequently show up to work with the kids without any TV cameras there. He did it solely because he cared about the kids and the community. And, you know, I know that he's been honored and recognized by the NFL for his humanitarian work, his charity work, and he's just such a fine gentleman. And now to see that he's got such a great golf game, I mean, I think his team won by 7 strokes. So, excuse me. So he's quite a golfer. And I think he's debating right now whether he wants to go back to Arizona this season or if his body has had enough. He's played for a long time, I guess. All I want to say, he's 34 years old, and I'm not sure if he's got enough game to win on the PGA Tour or even on the Web.com Tour. But if he keeps working on his game when it comes time for the Champions Tour, when he hits 50, he might have a professional golf career ahead of him. So congratulations to Larry Fitzgerald on his big win and just for being an incredible guy. Also, I wanted to recap briefly the event that took place right here in our backyard, the Boca Raton Championship, and a local fellow who's got roots in the West Palm Beach and Tequesta area, I believe still resides in Tequesta, I think, and hadn't won a lot, but did have a great career, of course, on the PGA Tour. Excuse me, his allergies are still bugging me. in any event, he edged out Bernhard Langer, the hometown Boca guy, and Mark Calcavecchio won. So it was kind of nice to see him win. So kudos to him. Another great event here locally. I'm sure they raised a lot of money for charity. We'll hear about that in the coming weeks when they tally it all up. So I'm looking forward to hearing that. Then I wanted to talk a little bit about next week's tournament. And that's only because it's a tournament that is a little closer to my heart because it's across the street from my office where I spend my days. And I get an opportunity to go every year. I don't typically travel around the country because I do have a day job here in Palm Beach Gardens. So I gotta be here. But when the tournament is right across the street from me, I do go. And unfortunately, I won't be able to make it on Thursday. I'll definitely be there next Friday and possibly over the weekend. And that's, of course, the Honda Classic. And the Honda Classic, we had Ken Kennerly on just a few weeks ago, the tournament director. And year after year, he manages to make the event better, make it more of a spectacular but more importantly, it attracts one of the best fields, second to perhaps a world golf championship event or a major event. And one by one, he's just been getting the best players, the, you know, folks like Justin Thomas and Rory McIlroy, to commit to playing in the event. Of course, Ricky Fowler, he's going to be defending his championship. But the one person that they were waiting on, which of course is the biggest ticket in golf, even though he's no longer the best golfer in the world, and that of course is Tiger Woods. And Tiger waited until the absolute last minute to make a commitment because he's playing this weekend at the Genesis out in California, and he was not 100% sure how he feels yet and how his body feels about playing back-to-back weeks on the tour. So he wanted to have an opportunity to play a round or two, and he had, I believe, until he made the turn today, round two, to make his decision. And he was a few strokes off the pace, maybe five or six strokes off the pace after Thursday's round one. And unfortunately, he did not get off to a good start today. As we speak, I believe he's still out there on the course, so I can't say for sure, but it does not look like he's going to make the cut. So while that's bad news for Tiger, because of course he wants to win, I'm not sure how that affected his decision, but he also did commit to play in the Honda Classic today, an hour or two ago. And, you know, I don't like dedicating all that much time to Tiger because, again, he's way back on the list of the best players in the world these days. Last I heard, maybe 160 or so. But he still is the number one draw. And this event is an event that I care about. It's very, very important to the local community. And having Tiger gets so much more publicity on TV, higher ratings, good competition. Even though he didn't make the cut, it seems that he's competitive. I'm not so sure that he's going to be winning majors or even winning tournaments. But he is competitive. He's not taking the spot of a better player, perhaps, that deserves to be there or something like that. So he deserves to play. And let's face it, he is our neighbor. He lives right here in Palm Beach County, and he should be playing in the Honda Classic. So I'm glad that he made that decision, and I'm looking forward to it. Also on the tour next week, for those of you who are keeping score, not only do I encourage you all to come and check out the best players in the world playing at the Honda Classic. Thehondaclassic.com is where you can get more information. But there'll be plenty of other. Well, I'm not even going to talk about that. I want to change gears. Enough on the golf. We'll get back to golf when we talk to our guests in a few minutes. But somewhat related to golf, last night I actually had an opportunity to go to a brand new restaurant called 1000 North in Jupiter. As it turns out, it's just up the block from Tiger's restaurant, which I've been to many times, and it's pretty good. This is part owned by Ernie Els, as it turns out. So, you know, that's pretty cool. And in any event, I was there as part of a large group, and we had a special menu, and the place is cool. I mean, it is absolutely beautiful. It's on the waterfront. It's beautifully modern designed. I felt like I was on a cruise ship eating in the dining room. The service impeccable. The menu expensive. The food, mixed. Most of the, I was with, like I said, a large group of people. Everybody loved what they had, except me. My meal was not what it should have been for the $100 that the food without beverages cost us for three courses. That is a bit pricey. A wonderful presentation of she crab soup where they put a little pile of crab in the middle and then they come and they pour your soup and then they come with the sherry. The problem is they didn't get all the cartilage out of the crab. So every bite I took, I was crunching on and had to pull those pieces out. Beautiful rack of lamb. Absolutely gorgeous. Other than it was 50% fat and, I was about six bites of meat on my rack of lamb. And then I got dessert for $100. So I was not happy, but other people had the 9-ounce filet mignon, which they loved. It looked beautiful. The house salad was enjoyed by everybody. My wife had the salmon, which she enjoyed too. The mahi-mahi went over very well with some of our guests that we were with. So kind of a mixed bag. The place just opened this past weekend officially. They had a soft opening for a week or two before that. Actually, this past weekend, Burt Reynolds celebrated his 82nd birthday there. Kid Rock was there and several other people. And, you know, it's give it a chance if you want is all I could say. But beware and make sure to bring a lot of money with you is the other thing. I did go on their website to look at their menu because I had this fixed menu and there were no prices on the menu on the website. So there's a reason when they don't put the prices down. So just a word to the wise. In any event, what we're going to do is we are going to take our first break. And in just a moment or two, we will be back with our guest, Jason Kleindienst. And he's the VP of Operations for Input, a great new putting aid that you will want to hear about. So stay tuned. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show. And we are back. And if your business needs industrial workers or if you're looking for work, you got to call Labor Finders. Labor Finders places for temporary or temporary to hire opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled or general labor positions such as plumbers, electricians, concrete workers, forklift operators, hospitality, office clerical and much, much more. Labor Finders has almost 200 offices nationwide. Near here in Boca Raton, they have offices in Homestead, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and in Jupiter. So if you need legal insured workers or if you're looking for work, call Labor Finders toll-free at 800-864-7749. That's 800-864-7749 or visit laborfinders.com. Back. And if you are anything at all like me and you've struggled with your putting, and trust me, mine struggles are very well documented over the past 40 years or so, you need to work on your game and you need to practice your putting, but you need to practice it the right way, because if you keep practicing what you're doing wrong, you're just going to stay wrong. So if you would like to find a little help or you need a little bit of help, I got just the product and just the guy to tell you about it. The product is called Input, and we've got with us tonight the Vice President of Operations for Input, Jason Kleindienst. Jason, are you with us?
I am. It's great to be here.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. And I was fortunate to have the opportunity to check out your product at the PGA Merchandise Show, and thought it was pretty cool, and I wanted to share it. And you know, not to take up too much of your time, because I want to hear all about it, but just to relive my angst and let everybody know where I'm coming from. I suffered with a bad case of the yips for decades, and finally solved the problem about 2 years ago by switching from right-handed to left-handed. And it got rid of the yips. But what happened was is now I have a completely new set of problems because now I actually have to worry about hitting my line, having the right speed, having a smooth stroke, because now I'm capable of doing all that. When you yip, nothing else matters. So I'm basically starting all over from scratch, and I thought that this was a great putter for a great putting aid for me. So I thought it would be good for everybody else. So without any further ado, why don't you start out? Whenever I have a guest with a product, I always kind of want to find out a little bit about the history, what brought you to the company, and how the product kind of first came about. So why don't you start right there?
Sure thing. So the InPut was invented by a fellow named Barry Herbst from up in Pennsylvania. Barry worked on a prototype over many years. He went through an entire series of different pieces until he perfected exactly what replicated his putting stroke. What Barry's putting stroke was a slightly inside to a slightly outside stroke,
mm-hmm.
which basically contoured to the way your body should move when you're most consistent. And it enabled you to have a more straight follow through, so you weren't influencing your ball outside or inside. So, in developing this tool, Barry needed someone to help him with some prototyping. So that's when we became introduced with Barry's new product, the InPut.
Now, I have to say that it's a daunting task to introduce a new product into the golf industry. The golf industry is full of giants that don't make it easy for the little guys to get started. So how did you cope with that reality?
Well, that certainly is very true. Honestly, the biggest crutch that we had was this product really works.
Mm-hmm.
Hands down, anybody can put it down, step up to it, set up, hit the ball, and they're going to see instant results. And there is nothing more convincing that you have something real, something tangible, and something that really works when the proof is when the ball goes in the hole every time.
There's nothing like that sound, of course, when you hear it hit the bottom. But for the benefit of our listeners,
we always golfed, and it was always so much confidence in what we were doing.
Well, I've worked with some psychologists, and they'll tell you if you can't putt, put the ball an inch from the hole, just so you can get used to hearing that sound. You know, don't kill yourself, and the sound of success will spur you on. But I was going to say, for the benefit of our listeners, since this is radio, we're talking about a putting device, and the best thing we could start out also now by doing would be to describe, if you could kind of paint a picture with words to describe what this device looks like, then we could talk about how it works.
Okay. Well, I'd like to start with the material that we use.
Mm-hmm, sure.
And that's really important. We use a high-density polyethylene that is 100% machined right here in the USA. It's hand-finished so that every product comes out looking exactly the same. They all work identical. And basically what you see when you look at the InPut is a product that's a little under 2 feet long. It's about an inch thick. And what you'll see is a black top surface with lines that are etched in. And inside the etched lines, you'll see a very white, a very contrasting surface. Now, the lines that are etched into the top of the InPut actually show you what is square to your target. So wherever you're set up and aligned to, those lines are square to that target.
Mm-hmm.
There's also an engraving on top that indicates where the ball will go. And you'll just set your ball right in front of the InPut, and you'll rest the heel of your putter against the curve and the angle that are on the face of the InPut, and you'll just smoothly and gently glide along that surface and strike the ball, maintaining squareness of your club face to the target the entire way through the stroke.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it almost reminds me way, way back in the day of teaching and learning aids, where they had those big round, you know, circular things that, you know, for a full swing, you would kind of groove your, you know, the swing the way it's supposed to be using those things, but for a putting stroke instead.
Sure. and the beauty of this InPut is that you're removing variables. So we all know that the variables are what cause us trouble. If we can't train consistently, if we can't do the exact same thing, we can't pinpoint what our problem is, so we can't fix it.
Mm-hmm.
So what the InPut does is it allows you to remove all the variables and just work on the ones that you need to. So if you have trouble with aligning, you can work on using the product to align two different holes. So you can read the green, you can set up, you can hit a couple balls, you can see if they're going exactly the same spot, knowing that you're being consistent, but you can see if you're missing one way or another, so you know that, hey, this is what I need to do to adjust to what I'm reading. If you want to work on just your stance or your stroke, you can use the product as a reference to where your feet are going in relation to the ball, in relation to the input. You can check to see if that ball is traveling in exactly the same path. If it's not, then you know you need to work on your stroke. So, you know, the beauty of this is you work on what needs to be worked on, and you just reintroduce those variables as you get more comfortable and confident in your putting stroke.
I kind of like the idea of doing things, not too many things at a time. Some instructors, at least for my purposes, I'm not that technical minded, and I have a hard time remembering when someone throws too many things at me. So one thing at a time, I kind of like. And I mean, again, there are some golfers, and obviously typically they're the better ones that can think about multiple things perhaps, but for myself, one thing at a time is best.
Well, you know, it's putting is not complicated in itself. You know, it's a series of steps that you go through. So mm-hmm. You step up, you read the green. You know, we all know this. We
yep.
step up, we read the green, we assess where the target is, and then we align to it. And once we set our stance, we don't have to worry about aiming anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You know, then we decide how hard do we need to hit it. And then we decide on keeping our face nice and square and our stance. And once we eliminate, or each time we pass a certain step, we shouldn't worry about that step anymore. Otherwise, we're just complicating it, and you know, we're asking ourselves to run into some trouble.
Yeah, no doubt. And now also, you know, I've got your product right here in the package still. I haven't been working with it because I hate to practice, unfortunately, but I need to. But part of the alignment, yeah, well, it won't happen. You don't get better without the practice. I have to admit that. But but it's here. It's calling out to me, telling me I need to get to it. But to get the alignment working, I know that you also have some string and some tees that you use to try and, you know, get the alignment right. Why don't you explain how that's done too, and how simple it is for somebody to use?
Absolutely. And I would like to start out by saying that if you'd like to understand 100% what I'm talking about, we have an excellent video on mm-hmm. our website,
yes.
www.inputgolf.com.
Mm-hmm.
So I will explain it to you really quick, but if you're visual learners, you want to see what I'm talking about, jump on there and check out the how-to videos. So basically, we include a string with the input and a couple of tees. And there's some instructions as well in how to set up a 7-foot string to work on your 6-foot or shorter putts. Now, using the string, you're going to be set up on flat terrain. So you're going to want to try to stay away from any breaks, any debris, obviously. And you'll set up your string, if you're right-handed, to the left side of the hole. If you're left-handed, it'll go to the right side of the hole. You'll pull the string back to 7 feet, keep it nice and taut, and then there's an engraved mark on top of the input that shows you a straight alignment to where the string needs to lie over top of the input.
Mm-hmm.
When you align that, you are able to slide the input closer to the hole or further away from the hole and practice at any of those distances. The string is going to show you perfect alignment when you're on perfectly flat terrain. We promote trying this and learning how the input works before you move to terrain that's not flat.
Mm-hmm.
Once you understand the process and how aligning the input works, then you can take it anywhere on the green and you can play any break and you can work on all kinds of different drills, like, you know, working on the speed, working on reading the green. So you take it anywhere.
Well, I enjoyed the benefit of not having to set it up. You guys had it set up, and all I know is I just went over there, I took a few putts, and they were going in the hole time after time. So something was working with it, and I was pretty amazed because, again, being somebody who's